Welcome back. So we are just getting off the scenic byway and onto Highway 101 South again. I don't know why this van is everywhere. Come on, buddy, you're going 30. We need to go 55 shortly.
Proceed 47 miles on US 101.
I think that's a either a Wi-Fi or a cell phone range extender sticking up on the roof. All right, this is only the second car in 3 days that has been going slower than me. And they're doing 43 and a 55. I will be patient, though. I can't tell. I think it's a Dodge. One of those ProMasters that I like. Wow, he's doing 37 and a 55. Ah, oh, thank you, buddy. Yeah, that's a nice van. It's a Ram. That's what I would want. If we were able to get one that was built out, and if we had to build it out ourselves, I would get a Ford Transit van. I told my wife, I said, I think that's the next thing we buy for traveling, 5-10 years from now. Just crossed Lost Man Creek. A little RV park there. But only one bar a single. Desolate, this section of Highway 101. Sun feels good. What a beautiful day. Lady Bird Johnson Grove to the left. sure how far though. Population 357. And we have 2 bars of service here. Oh my gosh. Some of these yards of these houses are just junkyards. Three bars, so it's getting better. Got a nice little market here and a Mexican restaurant, and that's about it. This video in Oric. It's pretty lengthy. Welcome back. So we are in Oric, California. South of Crescent City and north of Eureka. About in the middle of the two. On Highway 101 going south. Elk to the left. They're all lying down. There must be 50 of them. About half a mile away, fourth a mile away. Trinidad is 19 miles. That'll be the next stop, most likely. Oric to Trinidad. Oh, I love this section of coast. There's a bunch of wildlife, refuge, and state parks, and National Seashores, I think, in the next 20 miles, if I remember right. Here's the first one coming up. And we are on the coastline again, right by the water. You can see the ocean. Freshwater lagoon, the sign said. This is the area I thought I can get away with camping, if I wanted to. And I have 4 bars of service. Oh, it just went down to 2. So basically, you have limited cell service, but you got something, and now it's back up to 4. Oh, it says day use only, the signs. Probably wouldn't get away with it. There's a trailer though, I imagine they spent the night. it's we're coming up to the Humboldt Lagoon State Park and the Stone Lagoon in a few miles. Sit there for a few days and be warm. Take a shower in my shower thing. I need to buy some gallon jugs of water. Here's the Humboldt Lagoon State Park Visitor Center on the right. Coming up. Oh, it's little. I thought it would be bigger. And it's closed. Stone Lagoon Visitor Center. Yeah, it's tiny. Service here, it looks like. 2 to 3, it pops in and out. Oh, it looks nice, actually. Wow. I like it. Coming up, that's the one I remember. And there's a campground on the south side of it I was gonna try and stay at if I made it this far, but that did not happen. I would have had to drive another 80 miles basically to make it last night, and it would have been dark, I think. gear and it has white caps on it. Jeez. It's massive. A Jeep down there on the beach with a rooftop tent. This little gravel road here they turned off on. That would be a pretty cool camping spot. It's probably windy, but it would be kind of neat. Right on the lagoon, big lagoon. Some real food today. We will see. That's the big lagoon, Park Road, where they had camping. And I have one bar of cell service here, so we probably don't have much cell service, if any, there. Which is too bad. Trinidad is in 5 miles, Eureka 24. These will be my first California videos. Really excited about that. Oh, there's a rest area 2 miles. If I have good service, I might pull over. Our sunshine. Service to stop and sit there. Actually, I have no service. just lost it. It's like a decent rest area. For Trinidad on US Highway 101, and we are not gonna go there. It's only got 300 people.